My real name is Dumelo. My stage name is Maero. I'm from the Eastern Katlehong.
Yeah, I go by the name of first loaded stage name, and real name is Dumelo, and I'm from the Eastern K1.
Our success in AmaPiano. Since we've been in the game, we've been nominated for the Summers, which is we won one award for the best video. We sold platinum for all our singles we released.
As you said, we also been nominated, you understand? And with in terms of winning, you know, like the platinum sales, you know, it was something that was unbelievable, you understand? Because of, you know, when you produce, when we were still young, we used to see those, you know, guys, you know, maybe those guys to guys winning awards, you understand? But with me personally, I never even thought I would be one of the guys whereby would end up being nominated or winning platinum, you understand? So when we released our first song, you know, song that, you know, actually made us enter the industry, which was Love Which United. And you can imagine that how after a couple of months, we're like, you know, guys, you guys have a plaque, you know, the song is sold so much and people love it, you understand? So it was a true blessing and a true success. And also one of the successes, you know, as you said, is like traveling the world, you understand? We've traveled to Botswana, you understand? We've traveled to Lesotho, you know, we've went to Kenya, you know, we've also went to, you know, places like Dubai, you understand? So it's quite a huge achievement of whereby when you get to a venue, you understand? And then when people see your face, even though they haven't seen you on stage, when they just see your face from you, you know, entering from, you know, the backstage, and then be like, you know, when you peep up, it's like, oh yeah, oh, it's so full, be like, yeah, you know, I understand. So it's a great feeling, you know, immediately when you walk up the stage there, you know, without them, you know, yeah, without even the MC introducing you, they'd be like, you know, screaming MFR Souls, and then you'd be like, oh, God is good, you understand? So it's also a huge, huge success for us.
Who we've worked with, we've started the game with Kabzela Small, Kaba Kanao, Josiah the Disciple. We also worked with the late Ricky Rick, Oskido.
Okay, besides the top guys, we also worked with, you know, upcoming guys also. We've worked with, recently we worked with Basi. You know, I think in every project from, you know, starting from the previous one, we were working with Basi. And then, it's Basi most of the time, and we also have Mandy also. She's a young and upcoming one. And with the guys then, yeah, Petiabo Mzulu Gakulu, you know, Abahamba, we've got the Team and Essays, you know, we've got my new All-Star, we've got Boza, you understand? So yeah, we've worked with a couple of guys, you know, and yeah, even Shasha, you know, we've worked with Shasha, you know, the great Kamumpela. Producers, we've worked with so many guys. Producers.
Yes, we've worked with Pori. What software we use? We use Fruity Loops, mainly because it allows you to do everything on the software. You can record, you can produce, you can mix and master on the software. I've personally tried Reason. I've tried Cubase, but I think I'd rather stick with Fruity Loops.
We prefer Fruity Loops besides using it for a long time, you understand? But out of the software that I personally tried, between Reason and Fruity Loops, you understand? As you said, you know, Reason had too many limits, you understand? And there were just so many things that you had to download for Reason. But with Fruity Loops, you understand, it's more of a common software that most producers use, you understand? Yeah, more especially in the AmaPiano genre. If you don't know something from Fruity Loops, you understand, it's much more easier when you're collaborating or when you're in studio with another person. You can learn something out of the person. For example, if let's say we're in studio with Gabs and the Small, you understand, probably while he's working, there's just some shortcuts that he's gonna do there, which, okay, you know what, this is shortcut to doing this and that and this and that. Without him even knowing that, you know what, you're actually learning from him, you understand? And then eventually when you head to the next person is going to do something in a certain different way. So it becomes even more easier for you to learn how to learn things from the software and how to improve your skills in the software, because of eventually mafundi zintezintsha all the time and you learn new sounds and everything. Eventually when you're in your own private space, you'll be like, Ayazin, oh yeah, I saw this from this and that. And when you combine them together, yeah, it helps you improve, which, you know what, the way you say finding a corner, how fast do I do a song and everything. So it's user-friendly at the moment.
Yeah, self-taught and YouTube.
Oh, if I were to describe our piano as food. Okay, personally, if I would describe AmaPiano, I'd personally, not even food, I'd personally describe them as eggs, because I personally love eggs. You know, I eat in 7 days, I eat eggs probably 5 days, except for weekend, obviously. But, you know, not even breakfast. I can eat 4 eggs in the morning, I can eat 3 during the day, and I can eat 5, you know, for dinner. You know, that's how much I love eggs, and they never get old. You know, what about you?
I would say in your mental fit, because the piano is a cast, you know? So it's a casty thing, so I would say in your mental. I would personally love to work with Shekinah and Lira also, surprisingly, yeah.
Yeah, no, I definitely love Lira, you know, honestly. Because of, you know, when I listen to her songs, you know, I get too inspired, you know, by her voice. You know, her voice alone says a lot, besides listening to the lyrics of the song, but her voice says a lot to me.
Like,
yo, man.
Yeah.
Actually, I want to live voice like, actually, imagine, I want with you. Lord, have mercy. No matter what she says, you know, the voice is what actually driving. Yeah, the soulfulness, you know, and even what's accompanying her, or her band, or, you know, her producers, you know, they make it even more fun. And we've never really tried approaching Lira because of, you know, from, yeah, you know, judging from what she is now, and she's been traveling the world, and you understand, Guti, a lot of AmaPiano producers, they most probably tried her.
Yeah.
You know, even the, you know, the bigger guys, they most probably tried her. I think piano is not in her list, you know. She's not yet convinced.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say the future of AmaPiano, I would say I would like to see it around the world. It's already started. I mean, UK is already on AmaPiano, Dubai, Nigeria is also on AmaPiano, so yeah. Even more.
Yeah. I think AmaPiano is always gonna be there now, because of, if you can just imagine the contribution it's doing right now at the current moment. Even Abu Chris Brown, they haven't even went into, you understand? But obviously they're starting to get interested. So eventually, you know, after 2 or 3 years, you know, when it's growing even more broader, you understand? That's when they start to engage, you understand? And you know, AmaPiano still has a long way to go, and it's only gonna take one international artist to make it even grow bigger. I understand. And already, if you check social media, you know, some of them artists now, you know, they're starting to, even though they're doing the dance in the United States, the piece of the piano, you know, dance, you understand? Yeah, the piece of the piano, even dance, you understand? So they're starting to engage to it, you know, they're starting to understand it, you know. It's only now they're starting to understand it, you know. Oh, obviously in UK, Dubai, now they understand it, but in the United States, you know, it's only now so I can understand, which, okay, this sound, oh yeah, are we hearing this sound more often? You get on social media, TikTok, it's AmaPiano now, you understand? So, oh yeah, it's not quite a bad sound after all, yeah? Well, they say from it not to be a bad sound after all, it's like, let me just try one track and see, Ganti, boom.
It makes us feel great from studying the genre. We had so many critics, like, but you know, the sound is going to last for like a year, but we kept on going on. So
I'm sure you guys must be proud to see.
We actually very proud of Mina personally. I there was a point whereby I think this AmaPiano thing is gonna die very soon, because there was once a time whereby he has piano, you know, change the direction, lines into in a in a certain way that I won't mention.
Sound,
you understand?
The sound was
really the sound, even the lyrics at some point, you understand? So I even thought, I'm like, oh, imagine the upcoming guys, each and everyone wants to do this kind of, you know, piano. So I thought number is off. I only to find out, you understand, we tried changing it in a way from the Valka ones to, you know, Amantombazana, if you remember, you understand. We grew with Amantombazana, Love It Tonight. So everything started changing from there. Even the recent piano that's trending right now, you know, it's definitely doing a great job because of, I think more or less the international guys also understand it now. Yeah, but so it's a proud moment, you understand? Even though there's only a few of us who switch, you know what, hey, from where you come from, Bana, yo. It's a huge achievement, you understand?
Now we have millionaires.
Yeah, but
from AmaPiano.
You understand? Yeah. So, but for me, it's just a proud moment. Yeah, but they'll probably recognize it the day Saint Peter. So when I die, which I asked him, played a good role. Even it's always like that. About you when you're still alive, they don't usually say it.
Yeah.
But even some artists, kona bayi bakhala ukuthi ningappreciate mangisa phela. Angeke bese ngiappreciate, saka appreciate usaphila. But you know, the day ungasekho, that's when you'll be like, I'm fine, but he worked so hard. That's what he did. They opened so many doors for people, you understand?
Am I seeing someone?
Yeah, you need
appreciation.
For
people
to know, maybe
some of
their pieces.
Yeah. It's nothing. It's not a secret, I am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But you want to keep your stuff private, obviously.
Yes, obviously. Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you?
I heard Forces getting married, so.
No, very soon, don't worry.
Yeah.
We have been in a relationship, eh? Ish. Yeah.
So you are not those committing guys?
Yeah. I'm a very loyal, humble guy. 7 years down the line, huh? Yeah. I've been pushing this thing for 7 years, so it's time now, it's my time. time to, you know, Vela and Faga, you know, them young lobolas first, yeah, bro?
Yeah.
And test the waters. Okay, I'm gonna test the waters, but yeah, I know I have to do the right thing now.
To show them that you're serious.
Yeah, but you know, I prefer keeping it private also, you understand? Yeah. A private life is a happy life, that's what they say. So I'm following those footsteps of being private.
Yeah.
And so far it's working.
Yeah.
What are we working on? We just dropped a hot EP, it's out. And we make music every day.
What's the name of the EP?
It's T-Squared. We're currently pushing the song Forever, featuring Manuel Star, Boza, and... what's the song again? Yeah. I would like to add that they must get our EP, T-Squared, is out everywhere. Yeah, man, that's all I can say.
So far, the response we've been getting is a good response, I understand. And it so happened that, you know, the song that we chose as a single is a very good song. Yet, you understand, the people, there's a specific song that they love. I mean, most people, Batanda, take me back. It might be the second single. I mean, obviously, we just want to give it probably a month and just check the responses. You know, even those Hamba say Tratin, and then when you listen to the set and then just check which song they play the most, which song do they push the most, you understand? That's going to lead us into our next plan of us doing visuals for at least for one of the songs, you understand? So we're just waiting for the people to decide which one is better, you understand? But the response is good. I mean, I see, even though when you play those songs, you know, those 5, 7, or 10 people back, you understand? And it's so funny because we were in this group, I don't know which place, you know, a couple of places, this is Hambide, like, I don't know, I think it was 3 hours. But you know, much like he said, you know, busy playing, you know, shy stuff for exclusive, you know, and then this guy comes to me like, Mfana, can you please play Forever? Okay, no, sharp, I'll play it. You understand? And then the next guy, we have figure, Mfana, please don't forget this para. I'm like, oh, okay, so they have knowledge. And then this chick wears Mfana is like, she's like, hi, how are you? You guys are playing. And I said, how long are you playing for? I'm like, no, we're playing for 2 hours. Oh yeah, it's only 1 hour, 10 minutes. Can you please not forget this song? I'm like, Sipesil. I'm like, oh, okay. You understand?
People love different tracks.
Yeah, people love different tracks. So the most important factor is to try and just play all of them. Yeah, just play all of them. And you know, sometimes it happens that we start a set probably with the song, with the EP song, some of them. And then I want to expect at a later stage of the set. In time, if it's a 2 hour set, they're expecting it on the last hour whereby you would like successful new job, you understand? I think what keeps us together most is that we just learn to tolerate each other, you know, and we just learn to, you know, accept each other's differences, which okay. When I was very we are super. When he says we understand. Yeah. But I think it's better if we answer in this sort of manner, you understand? Yeah. So that it doesn't affect our name at the end of the day, you understand? So, and even now too, even me personally, I prefer with it, as much as I'm this kind, you understand? I mustn't do it, you know, to also affect him, you understand? Because of, obviously we've once had the challenge, but okay, you know what, a specific person who isn't in this way, sorry, and a specific person who isn't in this way, you understand? Yeah. So it's only a matter of, you know, just trying to be more careful, you know, about the brand, you know, don't only do things for you personally. You must also think, okay, I'm gonna imagine if I'm gonna go out and get drunk and then I sleep on couches there, everybody's watching. At the end of the day, people will not say, no, first I was drunk. They'll be like, those MFR guys, I saw them, hey, they were drunk there. This other one was vomiting, they're busy, you know, I understand. So I think it's one of the things that keeps us going, because we think for each other in terms of the brand also, I understand. And also, you know, we have our ways of solving whatever issue is there, you understand? Even though sometimes that's not going to be a problem, and then somebody, let's say, if Omunya is, you know, is pissed at one, probably get pissed for like a day after a day. It's fine. And then we'll talk through it probably in a short space of time. Somebody, let's say we at Scalini, for example, and then we're busy like having fun, and then obviously we're getting along again. Then this is like Antoine, my man. This is how we should do things. So. No, I hear you. Then it's done. You understand?
When you say on your side, man, like, it's more of like a brother kind of relationship more than a work relationship.
Yeah, I would say so, because Dallas is 7 years. It's been like 7 years now. So, I understand. I understand. So, yeah, it keeps us going.
With me personally, I know I don't, you know. We work with other people, we've been working now, you understand, you know.
But it doesn't make you want to
Okay, what advice can we give to young and upcoming artists? First and foremost, it's the basic one. You must be patient and you must work hard, you know. But also, by you working hard, you must also work smart, because of you know, nowadays, you know, it's not like before where most of the things used to be done probably via radio and, you know, visuals, you know. Nowadays, it's all about social media. So if you work hard and you work smart and you're always on social media, and after you working, you share your songs on social media, you know, eventually they will pile up. And by you sharing, probably say by you sharing one song to a friend, then the friend is gonna share it to another friend, then that friend is going to share it to another friend. Eventually, it will end up getting into, you know, very important hands. And then from those very important hands that get hold of the song, that's when they come back to you, be like, I'm fine, you know what? Man, there's this song that I heard from you. It's a very nice song. And then when you start revealing other songs, that's when you get the opportunity to get into the market in a proper way, you know? So working hard, being patient, you know, staying humble all the time, you understand? And out of everything, you must still try and open those doors, you understand? Because not everybody's going to give you a chance, but eventually out of the 10 artists that you approach asking for, you know, an opportunity to also try and make it, you know, one of them is going to give you a chance. But also on the other hand, you know, according personally for me, you know, sometimes you also don't need the bigger artists to actually grow in the music industry. Sometimes, you know, I know when you do things, you can only do things up to a certain limit. But, you know, for you to get to that limit, you have to start by here and then push it up to here. Then from here, that's when these bigger artists that, you know, that's when big artists and labels, that's when they start helping you to, you know, recognizing you even more. That's the most important thing. They must recognize you first, you understand? So it comes back to the very same point of which, you know what, go social media, you know, push as much as you can, you know, invest in yourself, basically. Invest in yourself, and then, you know, everything else shall follow.